Welcome to The Advocate, where thought-provoking topics are discussed with no holds barred here on Plus TV Africa. We basically call a spade by its name. Today, I'm talking about the future of works in Nigeria and how productivity will matter more than hours put into works. Raymond speaks on time management and attention management. Ruth will be talking about black tax and the increasing struggles of millennials to save. Why Felix rounds up this conversation with advocacy on good governance. Sit back and relax. After this break, we'll be here to dissect it all. Stay with us. The future of work. If there's one thing we should have picked in 2020 from COVID-19, it's how we must increase our flexibility and adaptability, especially with the way we work. We have seen several companies adopt the remote working structure, while a few traditional companies are struggling to keep up. I personally think that work has gone beyond 9 to 5, that is, resuming at 9 a.m. and closing at 5 p.m. In the coming years, employer time will no longer matter, as the workplace will be driven solely on productivity and not amount of hours put in the work. Prospective job seekers will begin to seek for companies that are flexible with their working system. What is the implication for CEOs and HR experts? We must now develop a new performance metric system that measures productivity and not by how many times I showed up in the office. Companies who do not quickly pivot into the realities of the future of work may soon begin to lose their greatest assets, which is her people.
Well, it's interesting. The dynamics is changing. Great. And each time there is a revolution, either by pandemic, or by human thinking, what order or whatever. I don't want to even use that word, what order, because there are a lot of controversies around this. But the long and short of everything is that we should try to evolve. Times have changed. We're in the, what industrial revolution are we? Fourth or what?
That's the
point. Yes. The industrial revolution is going from manual manual automation to remote automation. Yes. No, it started from human effort to manual automation, where you have to go through mechanics of doing things to reduce effort. But now it's even going beyond that one to remote automation. That means you can be somewhere and you'll be controlling something somewhere. So you don't have to be in a physical location. The idea of the advent of science and technology, and especially internet technology, has broken the barrier of connectivity of human resource. Before, you have to fly, sometimes you have to fly an expatriate down to your locality to do something. But in this era, you don't even have to do that. Somebody can be somewhere and correcting something.
Exactly.
So yeah. Ruth, I mean, what you think?
I mean, just as what he said, I remember some firms in Nigeria had issues with millennials asking for opportunities to work from home. Now that COVID-19 happened and everyone was forced to work from home, and they've seen that productivity really did not even drop. In fact, what even you can find increased. Is that it increased. So there's now the struggle of, in fact, most of these firms don't even want to ask their staff to return back to the office.
Because they're saving a lot of money.
Exactly, they're saving a lot of money. Operating costs in that entire aspect has been removed. So all they just have to be concerned is how to ensure that the staff deliver. And one thing I always like to tell people is that millennials, kind of, they like to own their jobs.
True.
They really like to own their jobs. They like to ensure that no one comes and tells them that they're not pulling their weight. And because of that sense of responsibility, everyone is able to work from home. And these days, you find people applying for jobs in the US and living here in Nigeria. You have people. I know some people that are working for companies in the UK and the US, and they are here in Nigeria, earning dollars, earning foreign currencies, you know, and still able to deliver. So work has changed. COVID-19 has changed the way we do our work. And I think companies that do not even, companies that still work in the ways of the old would stand the risk of losing quality hands, because most, I understand some, I've spoken to some tech people in the past, and they're like, if you tell me to come to the office, you know that I'm not going to work for you again. So, and they're not the only ones I've met like that.
Awesome. Let's quickly take Raymond. What do you think about this? You know, just chiming your thoughts on that.
Yeah, so I think that the future of work, in talking about the future of work, I think it's important for people to understand that it's important to stay ahead of change. So what's happening now is that change is happening. I heard when you mentioned about people that have been swept off by, you know, by the situation. That's because they are not able to stay, you know, ahead of change. You mentioned about new metrics for measuring productivity. You know, most times some people are still very traditional about how their work is being done. They want to see you do it. They want to ensure you are standing up and sitting down when they want you to do it, without knowing that, you know, the world has completely changed. But I also understand why these traditional thinkers have those challenges. You know, that let's also take away the fact that there is also this issue of competence. There's this issue of competence against discipline and accountability. So you also want to look at these three things. Someone is competent, but the person is not disciplined enough to keep to time. So you have to keep struggling. You have to keep calling the person on phone. You have to, it's most times they just get go offline completely, and they are not able, they are not in touch as at when you need them, and they also don't get to produce those results as when you need them. And it becomes a very big challenge with traditional thinkers. They also have to make do with the fact that change is here. No matter how much you don't want to accept it, if you want to, it's like pregnancy, you know, the more you want to keep it, surely by 9 months, something has to happen.
Thank you so much, baby.
We need to start changing our minds, our mindset on how we accept the future of work, to know that, you know, you can actually do more, you know, by the way it was done originally.
Thank you so much. So change is here, and we've got to find new ways to really focus on productivity and then increase our metrics or how we measure actual work, you know, as opposed to, you know, just hours of work. So up next is Raymond. Please do stay with us.